Hey everyone, it's Yolanda. Welcome to my very first, take those glasses off, we might get the glare. Welcome to my very first official vlog here on Yoli Bean. I just wanted to do hopefully a super quick video and just say thank you so much to all of you for responding to my question in the last video that I did, 9 questions answered, the tag by Monica. And I asked your advice. What did you think about me starting to vlog? Something that I had wanted to do. I had wanted a blog, but I'm not very good at it. So I thought, what about a vlog? And, you know, just here and there, talk about stuff, take you on little field trips. And so many of you responded so kindly. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. So the masses have spoken. Most of you think that I should leave everything here on one channel. So I think that's what I'm going to do. We'll just see how it goes. I will title each video appropriately, whether it's a craft video or whether it's a blog. And feel free to pick and choose what you want to watch and comment, ask questions, and all that good stuff. The only thing I ask, honestly, is like I said in my last video, the thing I don't like is that if you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all. If you have a question about something that I said, there's a way to approach each and every one in a nice, respectful way, because I do respect other people's opinions as long as you're not being mean, you know, as long as it's something in a respectful way. Go ahead and feel free to hide behind the thumbs down, because you can thumbs down me till the cows come home and I'll never know who you are. Those don't bother me. But like I said, if you don't have anything nice to say, one, don't say anything at all, or just choose to say it in a way that is, you know, constructive criticism, or hey, I had a question, why did you blah, right? Okay. So of course I'm gonna get someone that's gonna be mean, but we'll deal with that when it comes. So I just wanted to do a random, really quick, what I did today, and let you know something that happened while I was out to breakfast this morning that really, really touched my heart. And that's what I'm going to share. So that will be my very first vlog. It's in regards to friendship. So I had a lot of errands I had to run today. It's Monday. I had a lot of stuff to do. And I told myself that it was like a really purpose, like a strong desire of my heart to get better organized with my time. I waste a lot of time. I get sidetracked. I'm like a deer that sees a sparkly thing. Like, I'm easily distracted. Excuse me. And so I find that I don't get a lot of stuff done because I'm too busy doing a lot of stuff and not finishing one thing. So I had already told myself that I was going to give myself, try my hardest to do one day a week where I accomplish the errands that have to get done for the week. I'm not taking into account the last minute run to the market for something if the need arises, but if there's multiple things that have to get done outside of the house, I'm going to try to knock them all out in one day. So today was my day. I had to go get my husband's tag, so I went to AAA. I had to go fill up my gas tank. I needed to go to Staples. I met my friends for breakfast, and I purposely, because they asked me, did I want to do Monday or Tuesday, and I purposely said Monday, so that way I knew where we were meeting was really close to AAA, and there you go. So I kind of did just like a little circle of errands, and then I was back home. So we'll see how it goes. I'm really going to really try, and any tips that you have are greatly appreciated on what works best for you when it comes to running your house and your time. And I work nights so that I could be home with the kids. I quit my full-time job, my Monday through Friday big girl job. I quit that 14 years ago. I actually quit on the day of the Columbine shooting. So I'll never forget, it was April 20th, 1999. I was home on maternity leave and I was supposed to go back to work that following week, and I decided to quit and stay home. If those of you that are new to my channel, you might not know that I have 7 children. They range in age from 29 down to my twins, which are 7 and a half. So when I quit my job, my oldest wasn't in high school. She was a freshman in high school. And then I had one in like the 7th grade and one going into middle school. So not only did I want to be home with a new baby, but I didn't get a chance to be home when the older ones were young, and I really wanted to be there. It's real important at that age that someone be around. So I quit my big girl job. So ever since then, I've worked nights, And that way my husband's home with the kids and we do, you know, the trade-off. I go to work and he comes home and I go to work. And it works, you know, for now. Eventually I'll have to go back or will want to go. Or I don't know. Maybe I won't. I don't know. But for now, this is the way my schedule is. So I'm trying to get better at making more use of my time. I'm trying to get better at making the best use of my time. So today I ventured out to breakfast at Panera, my favorite place for breakfast, with my two friends and one of my friends. Her sister's here from Albuquerque, New Mexico, visiting. Kathy and Deborah are my friends. We met when I worked at Joann's about 11 years ago. Kathy has worked there about 10 years, and Deborah is a retired teacher, but she's always worked. Ever since she was about 17, she's worked two jobs. She just likes to put money away and have money to spend and splurge and whatever. So she says she's just always worked two jobs. She worked Friday through Sunday, and worked Friday through Sunday in the evenings at Joann's, and then she taught Monday through Friday. So anyway, she recently retired, so her sister came out to visit her. They're just having fun, you know, monkeying around, shopping, doing all that fun stuff. So we met up for breakfast, and Deborah's sister's name is Jackie. And I'm going to put a picture in the end so you can see the ladies that I am mentioning. In the picture, the very tallest one would be Deborah, the middle-sized one would be Kathy, and then the shorter one with the gray sweater would be Jackie. So anyways, we met for breakfast, and it was just so nice to see them. This morning was really hectic, and I know all of you moms can relate. It's that Monday morning, any morning, you overslept, you're racing around, come on, let's go. Anyways, got out of the house, got everybody off to school, but you know, when I get that last kid out of the car, it's like, whew, good gravy, like tiring. So anyways, when I walked into Panera, my friends were already there, and man, it was so good to see them. Friendship really does a number on you. I mean, it could really like lift the weight of the world off your shoulders, or so it feels like, just for that time that you're with those people that you love so much. So, you know, we got our breakfast, we hugged, and happy to see you, haven't seen you in a long time. And I see Kathy more than I see Deborah, and I haven't seen Deborah's sister in, it's been a few years. It's been a while, because when she asked to see a picture of the twins, she commented like how she hadn't seen them since they were babies. So it's been a really long time. So anyways, we got our food, we got our coffee, and then we were laughing and talking and just having a great time. And from across the room, this lady walks towards us, and just the confidence in her walk as she was coming towards us, it looked like she was coming over, like she knew someone from the table. That's what I thought. Well, maybe she knows Kathy, maybe, you know, she knows Deborah. And as she walked over, she stands at the end of the table and she goes, "Isn't friendship such a great thing?" And her eyes were kind of teary. And so within a few seconds, I totally figured out she didn't know any of us. And I said, "Yes, it is, isn't it?" And I reached up and I grabbed her hand, because she's standing like right around where her hand's like my level right here. I go, "Yes, it is, isn't it?" And she says, "I have been watching you girls from across the room, and I'm just so jealous." She goes, "It's just so beautiful to see such good friends." And it totally touched my heart, like our display of love and affection and laughter and pure, obvious happiness caught someone's eye. You know, the only thing that made me sad was that she said she does have a friend, but they're not close, they don't live close, so she longed for that. So I invited her to sit with us, and she said, you know, that she couldn't, she was with her hubby. I invited him to sit with us, and she goes, "Oh no, he won't." But I did tell her, I come to this Panera often. If you ever see me in here, please feel free to join me, I would love your company. So it was just so touching, because I took that moment while that lady was still there, and I told her, I go, "You know what, while you're here, I'm going to tell these girls how much I love them." I go, I'm telling my friends, I said, "I love you all so much from the bottom of my heart. You mean the world to me." And friendships are amazing. Some friendships will last a really long time, and some aren't meant to be in your life. Some are there just for a short time, and they don't bring what you need. And there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with knowing a certain relationship isn't right for you. But the ones that are, the good friends that you know that make you feel that way, like that instant joy and that stress relief and that happiness. And when I left there, I felt like I was walking on air. I had laughed so hard. I was so just so filled with love. I went about my day and did all the other things that I had to do without a care in the world. But what I was going to say is those relationships that are in your life, whether it's one friend, two friend, whatever, you need to nurture those. You need to let that person know how much you love them, how much you value their friendship. And what I've learned as I've gotten older, that, you know, that title friend, we use it way too lightly, way too lightly. Like, I don't have a lot of friends that, that are like that dear to my heart. I want to say I have maybe 4 or 5 friends, and 2 of them were in that room. So, there's not a lot of people that I hang out with all the time. I mean, I have a lot of acquaintances and people that I do care about and, you know, that I see, but those people that truly just fill you with love, and those relationships you need to make sure that you nurture and take care of and let them know how much they mean to you and how much you value that. There was a quote that I read one time, and now I'm going to totally forget who it's by. I'd have to go get my, I have my Yoli decks on my desk because it also has addresses. It's about friendship. Let's see. And if I could find it real quick. Sorry about that. I started this Yoli decks, if you've seen one of my older videos. Oh, okay. It's by Socrates. Anyways, let me get back to tell you really quick about the Yoli decks. I have an altered Rolodex that I just write quotes. I mean, it has a whole bunch of stuff. Quotes, addresses, birthdays, all of that stuff. But one little section is all quotes. So I write them down. This is a quote by Socrates. And it says, "Be slow to fall into friendship, but when thou art in it, continue firm and constant." So that should just say something about friendship. Anyways, had a really nice day, and I honestly hope that I see that lady again. I really hope that she comes in one day when I'm there, and I hope she sits with me, because I would love to have her company. So after I left there, I did all my errands and came home and grabbed a little bit of lunch, and then made a couple phone calls, and then it was time to pick the kids up. We took them to Yogurt Land, and we just got home, and now I'm going to finish up my mail, that kind of stuff. I have to call and make a couple doctor's appointments, and then I'm going to start cooking dinner, and then hubby will be home and homework and all that, and then there, that's just my day. So I'm just your average girl, just a squirrel trying to get a nut. So anyways, thanks again to all of you. Thank you so much for taking your time to comment. And leave me comments and questions. Excuse me. Leave me comments and questions on this video. I want to know what you want to know about me. I can't guarantee I'm going to honest everything. I'm going to answer everything. No. What I do answer, I will answer honestly. But I can't guarantee you that I will answer every question. I babble, right? Yeah, I can't tell you, because, you know, some might be too personal, and like my husband, he is Mr. Privacy, you know, don't be putting my picture in my face, anything. He's, you know, that old school, the internet's the devil. So anyways, let me know what you want to know about, and I'm planning to do some, you know, some field trips, and I want to do way more Pinterest recipes. And some videos on those, and some Pinterest stuff, and just, so let me know what you want to hear, what you want to see, what you want me to talk about, and other than that, it'll just be random vlogging. Welcome to my random vlogs. So thanks for watching, and have a nice evening. I'm going to finish up this stuff, and get about my business. So until I see you again, have a good one. Bye.